Extending from Alaska to Patagonia, the Pacific Flyway is the major north-south route for millions of migratory waterfowl. And as they migrate over these thousands of miles, each species must find suitable stopping over areas to feed and rest. Several areas in Northern California provide this prime habitat, which means that the hunting in these areas can be spectacular, as long as the habitat remains intact and the duck and geese populations remain strong. Today, we're hunting in Northern California's Sutter County near Yuba City with local guide Raith Herford, who has his brother and father with him in the blind. Raith has a great dog to work with, a prime location, and a decoy spread with all the added tools for a successful hunt.
Most of the time, the birds will come in and they'll come through the fog and you'll see them. They'll be kind of timid and scared and they'll just ease their way into the decoy spread. They normally do a circle around the edge of the decoys and then you'll call them back in and get your shot. And so that's what we're doing right now. We're watching these birds and they're kind of just barely going around the edge of our decoys, but pretty soon they'll start working in. They'll get tired and they'll want a place to land, and they don't know where the close zone is on the refuges and their sanctuaries where they've been staying. They came out last night to feed and then now they're lost. And so what will happen, the birds will get tired and then they'll start working really well into the decoy spread. So we're expecting to have some shots here real soon. Well, that's one down. Get the bird, pup. Little teal, they're kind of hard to hit. Good boy, pup, good boy. Bring him here, bring him here. Go lay down, back. Little hen teal.
Lay down.
We keep the dog away from the blind, so when we start shooting, for one, it's a real safety issue. The dog won't end up getting shot. It won't run in front of you while it's trying to mark the birds. The dogs like to stand up to watch where the birds are going to fall, and then they mark them, and then they go out and retrieve the farthest one, and then make their way back and start retrieving the closer ones. But if you have them sitting by the blind when he jumps up to mark the bird, it has happened where your dog could be shot. So we like to train our dogs to go down to the end of the check and at least 10, 12 yards away from the blind. We got some birds above us right now. That was a big mallard right there, and it was a single duck. So this time of year, you know, a lot of singles come around in the fog and that, but you're liable to kill anything out here. We are set next to the close zone at Sutter Refuge on Bell Farms property, and what's going on is you get ducks floating off the close zone all the time, and they get out in these fields, and that right there was a big mallard. The last one we shot was a teal. Today we're in the fog, you never know what we're going to kill. Come on, pup. Drop him. Go lay down. Back. Go lay down. No jewelry. Come in, boys. Two down.
I'm already
pup! Pup! Over!
Hey! Over here, pup!
We got two.
Yep.
You'll get two birds at one time. He's pretty smart. Good boy, pup.
Yeah, boy, pup. Bring him here, pup.
Two birds at one time. With a green-winged teal. Drake.
Come on, pup. Go lay down. Come on, pup.
Go lay down. Back. Good boy. A lot of times you'll be sitting here and you'll just watch down there and you'll see your dog's head move. And just by the way he's looking, you can tell that he's watching birds coming in. So you'll look that direction and there'll be birds right there just working their way in your decoy. So, you know, a lot of different guides in that, and a lot of different hunters, they can sit here and look one way and they can watch their dog look over the top of him and he'll be looking the other way and they'll know when birds are coming just by the way their head's moving and the look in their eye. So you can just, like I said, a lot of times just watch your dog and you'll know when birds are coming in the other direction. So you got an extra set of eyes. When your dog's been out hunting as often as our dogs hunt, then you get used to their habits too.
Pup, back! Pup! bird. Come here. Come here. Come. Hey.
Gadwall.
Yeah. Oh, Bob.
Bring him here, baby. Bring him here. Bring him here. Bring him here. Go lay down.
Oh, yeti.
Big gadwall. They got your yellow feet.
Lay down by you.
Right, 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 right. Here you go. Good job, guys. Yeah, coming out here hunting is not just about the hunt. It's about spending time with my family and my friends. And, you know, we work all week. And, you know, fortunately, I get to work out here all week. But my brother works in Sacramento, and I get to see him, you know, not as often as I'd like. And we get to spend quality family time, friend time out here, and enjoy ourselves. And if we kill a bird, that's fine. If we don't, that's fine too. But, you know, we spend 4 or 5 hours out here, you know, on the weekend and, or whenever we can get away and have some good family and friend time. So it's a lot more to hunting than just, you know, coming out here shooting birds. It has a lot to do with just spending some good quality time with your friends and family. So that's the big part of hunting, probably the biggest part, you know. You get to watch your dog, you get to call the birds, and you get to shoot your gun too. But spending quality time with the family and friends is where it's at when it comes to hunting. And, you know, I have 4-man and 8-man blinds, and I have a lot of friends and family. So I get to have a lot of good days throughout the duck season. There's 100 days in the season. And we're going to enjoy as many as we can together for as long as we can, you know. So my dad's dad hunted, and of course he hunts, and I hunt, and now my sons are hunting. So that's what we're doing out here. Just, you know, besides hunting, we're going to spend some good quality time together.
Get him, pup. Get him. Get the bird. Come on. Good boy. Bring him here. Good boy. Come on, bring him here.
The spinning blade is we call it a goal post, or you can call it a blade. And what it is just a piece of sheet metal that's painted brown on one side, white on the other. And as it spins, it looks like when a duck's going to land, its wings flapping, and it draws the ducks to come in real close to you. It's you know, December 1st, you're allowed to start using it. And every year we watch our numbers go way up using the spinning decoy. And you know, you can take an average spot and turn it into a pretty good spot by having that. So it's nice for the guys that can't afford a real high dollar duck club. You know, you can use that spinning decoy, and you can actually kill a few birds instead of going out killing nothing every day. But one spinning decoy is probably as good as 500 decoys, just a regular duck decoys. The water movement on the water is for when the ducks, if you ever watch ducks swimming in the water, they create little ripples in that. So sometimes these ducks can be fooled by just putting a little water movement on the water. So what we have, it's called a mallard machine. It's just basically a trolling motor head under the water with a couple decoys attached to the arms to it. And you just hit the button from the blind. It creates water movement, and it helps decoy the birds in a little tighter. You know, on a soft weather day like today with no wind, it's a perfect thing to have to help you get the birds a lot closer.
When the birds really start to fly in this area, it's easy to appreciate how challenging it is to coax just a few to come in close enough, and also how important it is to have adequate habitat up and down the Pacific Flyway. If you'd like more information about duck and goose hunting in California, or how you can help preserve the future of migratory waterfowl, then contact the California Waterfowl Association today.